Today we're going to talk about how to install dual Z steppers on the BigTreeTech SKR Pro version 1.2. So the first thing I need to explain is where our steppers are located. So we have our X stepper, our Y stepper, our Z stepper. Remember, it has two ports for NEMA steppers, but we're only going to use one in this case. We also have our E0 stepper, our E1 stepper, and our E2 stepper. So this would be your first extruder, your second extruder, and your third extruder. In this case, we're only interested in the Z stepper, E1, and E2. So the E0 stepper will be ignored because this will be an extruder. So what we need to find out is what to set for the jumpers to use these. So what I'm going to be working with are TMC 2208s. And notice how I have cooling fins on one of them. Normally they'd all have cooling fins and they'd also be cooled with a cooling fan. But for now, I'm just talking about how to set this up. So what we need to do is first figure out what the configuration is for the jumpers. So we're going to go over the browser in a second. And on the browser, what we're going to do is go to the BigTreeTech SKR Pro version 1.1. And in here, there's the SKR Pro version 1.2. So I'm going to open that up. I'm going to go to manual. And then I'm going to go to the actual user manual. So inside here, it outlines what the settings are on the board. So down below, there's going to be some information about how to configure this. So there's a couple of things I want to point out. First is this. This is the jumper for USB power. When using the steppers, you actually want to be on the power for VCC and in. So this will be direct power to your board. So that's the first thing we have to consider to make sure that that's jumped correctly. Now let's check to see what the actual steppers look like. So down here, they start with a step dir mode. We're not using that. That would be like an A4988 or a DRV8825, and they show what the jumper pins would be that you would need to jump. But down a little further, we'll find the UART. With UART, that's our configuration for the TMC 2208s. So it says that we need to be on the UART jumper pins. So that means we've got to remove some. So when we go back over to the board, what we're going to do is we're going to pop out the Z-axis pins for the jumpers, and we're going to place the UART jumper right here and then push it down. Then we're going to do the same for the E1 or second stepper. So we need to remove these and then place the jumper right here for UART. And then we do it one more time. So we'll pop these out. And we'll place the jumper in place. So now that we have everything jumped, of course, I've just misaligned this, so let me align it better. There we go. There seems to be some debris in there that I want to clean out first. This is from a previous tutorial. There we go. So, in order to place these in place, we need to look at them and see where the colors are. In this case, we want to align the colors. So, we're going to slide that in. But before we do that, I'm actually going to connect the stepper motors so I can see everything that's going on. So, as you can see, it's notched. So, I'm going to slide that in for Z. Then, I'm going to pick the next one and slide this in as well. And then finally, I'm going to do the very last one, which is over here. But I placed one of them in the wrong spot, so I'm going to pop this out and I'm going to place it in the second stepper. So what we have here is our first Z right here. Whoop, pardon me. And then we have the jumpers for this that are on, so it means you're only using one. Then we have the second extruder and the third extruder. This is E1 and E2. That's how they numerically specify them. So we're going to place this in with the correct colors. Remember, you're going to use a cooling fan and fins when you use this in normal operation. Place this one in here as well. And then this one in here. So now that we're all set there, we do have to wire up the board. Now it's currently powered down, so I'm going to leave the power cord up above for a moment to keep it out of the way, or actually down here. And I'm going to connect the actual power cables for the moment. So as you can see, I've marked red wherever voltage is, and the unmarked one is actually ground. So I'm going to slide this in for the power for the motors. This is the stepper motors. And I'm going to tighten these down with a screwdriver. So those are nice and tight. Now we need to do the board logic, which is the same thing over here. Just have to align these. It's going to take a second. So I'll just do one at a time here just to save time. So there's the voltage. Now we need to do the ground. Slide that in. Tighten that down. And then we're going to put the shield down for safety. We're also going to double check to make sure our power is set to direct power. That way our steppers will operate allegedly correctly. And we'll also not connect this at the moment. So next we're going to pop out the SD drive and place it in our USB converter so we can plug it into our computer. And just so you know, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So let's go over to the computer. And on the computer, we're going to go to VS Code. Inside VS Code, we actually need to open our actual project. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the File Explorer, then Open Folder, then Downloads, then Marlin 2.0, then Marlin 2.0, then Select Folder. Inside here with the newest version of Marlin, we need to check a couple of things that I'll go over one at a time. But first, what we'll do is we'll go into the Marlin folder, and I'll show you where you can check the version. It's actually located right here in version.h, which is 2.0.8. That's just so you know where you're working with. Now we'll go to configuration.h, and we're going to search on motherboard. And this is what we need to reset because it's set to the ramps. So we're going to go to source, core, boards.h, and we're going to search on SKR underscore pro, and we're going to copy the SKR pro motherboard name. Then we'll minimize core and source, go back to configuration.h, and paste it right here. Next, we need to change the serial port to -1. And now that that's set, what we're going to need to do is actually go to the steppers. So we're going to search on A4988, and this brings us to our steppers, which in this current version they've enabled your X, Y, and Z steppers, as well as E0 or your first extruder. But what we need is Z, then we need the second Z, which is right here, so we'll remove the comment, and we'll do the same for the third one right here. Now what we'll do is we'll grab the TMC2208 and copy that, and then we'll paste it for the first Z, the second Z, and the third Z. Down here, they finally adjusted this down to about 400, so it's closer to the value of your steppers instead of 4,000. But this is interlinked with your advanced configuration, and I'll show you this real quick. If you search on 800, may take a couple of tries, it'll bring you to the advanced TMC steppers. So what we're looking for is our first Z, and the value 16 is tied to 400. So if you double 400, that means you've got to double the 16. They also have something about chaining your actual steppers. I'll let you investigate this on your own, but the actual documentation is written up here and they talk about it. So now that we've actually got these set up, we actually have to search on dual space stepper. And down here we have our Z steppers. So when we're using these Z steppers, there's up to four that you can do, but we're only using three. So we're going to change that to three. And there are other settings that will then become enabled down here that you may work with, such as inverting. That's in case you need them to go the opposite direction. But that's all you need to know about this for the moment. I'm actually going to turn on TMC debug as well. So I'm going to search on TMC underscore debug, and I'm going to go to monitor driver, and I'm going to remove the comment. Then I'm going to search on the second one. This is so we can use the G codes and remove the comment as well. Now that that's all set, we need to set up platformio.ini. And it's a little different now because the Mega 2560 is our default environment. Normally we'd search in here, but this has changed. They've now linked them to separate files. So we have to go up to the INI folder and we have to find our actual stepper. And in this case, the quick route to figuring it out is going to source core boards.h. It's the STM32 folder that we're looking for. So let's see if we can find it in the list here real quick. And so it's STM32F. So let's minimize this for a second. Go up here and find the STM32F. And it's not in this folder, so let's go to the next one and search on SKR underscore pro. And we don't see it here, so let's go to the next one and do the same search. And there it is. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to minimize the INI file for the moment, go back over to platformio.ini and send or paste that value in there. The other thing we need to consider is the .pio folder has the Mega 2560 currently in it. So we're going to do a clean to get that out. This may take a few seconds or it might be right away. Then we're going to do an actual build. So the checkbox right here will do the build for us. So let's click on that. And keep in mind, if you have a failure during your build, what you can do, well, we have one right here, is click the build button again. And if you have a third value, or excuse me, a third failure, that means that something is broken. So find the first red thing that occurs and correct it, then recompile again. But usually when you have to do a second build, it means something wasn't built in the right order. And that's why you have to do a second build because now it exists. So as soon as this finishes, what we're going to have to do is actually copy it over to our drive. And right now we have firmware.cur on the drive. That was the last build that we had. But this is actually firmware.bin that's converted to cur after it's finished. And of course, everyone asks, is it a cursor file? Yes, it's considered a cursor file, but it's actually a binary. If you were to rename it to firmware.bin in lowercase, it would reload and rename itself to firmware.cur. So let's go back over and see how the build went. It looks like it took about 40 seconds. So we're going to go to the .pio folder, then the build folder, then BigTreeTech SKR Pro. And down here, you can see firmware.bin. So we're going to right-click on that and say Reveal in File Explorer. Then we'll right-click again, and we'll send it to the USB E drive. Over here, you can see it's now arrived. So we're going to go back over to the workbench, and we're going to install this in here. Next, we're going to plug in our power for USB. It doesn't power the whole board. Then we're going to grab the cord for our actual power supply and plug it in. And keep in mind, there's one thing I haven't shown you, and that's adjusting the power for the actual power source you're using. So I'm going to show you that real quick before I do this. If you have a different power supply, such as a 24 volt power supply instead of a 12, this may be relevant. So I'm going to go over to VS Code real quick and show you this. In VS Code in Advanced, we'll search on 12 volts, being 12 and then V. And there should be a setting in here that you can set for that power. So there'll be a power supply setting right here, I believe, that you can specify. Whoop, it's going to take me a second to find. Well, there used to be one. It looks like they may have moved it, but there was a way to adjust your power to your power supply to optimize your stepping. So I think that it may have changed, or it's for just choppers. So you're going to have to change this to here. So that's the actual setting change right there. So keep that in mind in the future if you're using it. I prefer 12 volts just because it's easier for me to control. But let's go back over to the desktop and see what happens. So I'm going to power this up. I'm going to try and move this out of the way. So the board is under power, so try not to touch it. Normally, you'd run fans on your steppers. Now we'll go over to Pronterface and we'll see if we can make the actual steps. So inside Pronterface, you can see that we don't know what the actual board is. Right now, it says COM port 7 might be it. We can choose that for now, but we can check in Device Manager real quick to see what our actual board is. So type device, and you'll see Device Manager pop up. Then you'll go to your ports, and COM port 1's always a default usually for the computer, so it's 17 in this case. So we're going to correct this by clicking over here and adding a 1. Then we'll try and connect, and it does say connecting, printer is now online. So let's check our steppers real quick to see if they're okay by typing M122 and pressing enter. And as you can see right now, they all say okay. So we know that they're allegedly functional. So what we'll do next is actually test to see that they work. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to move forward 10 with the Z-axis and see what happens. So it looks like it's functioning correctly and they're all in sync. So let's move back 10 and see if they work, and they do. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.